Hi friends, we are about to illustration of the law. Thanks for subscribing to our channel. Thanks friends. Let us illustrate the law of the EQ marginal utility with a numerical example. Suppose the consumer is prepared to spend all of his money income. Example, rupees 20 on two goods. Say X and Y. Further, market price of two goods are rupees 3 and 4 rupees respectively. Now the marginal utilities of goods X and Y are shown in this picture. In views of the explaining consumers, maximum satisfaction and the concurrent equilibrium positions, we have to divide marginal utilities of X, MUX, by it is the price rupees 3, and marginal utility of Y, MUY, by rupees 4. Reconstructing the above table by dividing marginal utility of X, MUX, by rupees 3 and marginal utilities of Y, MUY, by rupees 4, we get marginal utility of expenditure as shown in this picture. Marginal utility of expenditure, now table units MUX by PX, MUY, PY, now units 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, MUX by PX. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7. Now, MUY by PY. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. If you the consumer purchase the combinations of the units of X and two units of Y, he fulfills all the equilibrium conditions mentioned above. Example, ratio of marginal utility to price of good X must be equal to the ratio of marginal utility to price of good Y. Second one, income and expenditure must be equal. And third one, maximum satisfaction. First condition is MUX by PX is equal to MUY by PY is equal to 8. Second condition is Y is equal to E, where Y is equal to income and E by expenditure. QX into PX plus QY into PY is equal to 4. 1 3 plus 2 1 4 is equal to 20, where QX is equal to quantity of X, QY is equal to quantity of Y, PX price of X good, PY price of Y good. By adding all the marginal utilities of both the goods, we will get total utility. Example, 114 plus 68 is equal to 122. Therefore, consumer will be in equilibrium when he is buying 4 units of X and 2 units of Y and spending rupees 20 on them, and gets total utility equal to 182 units, which is the maximum if he spends his income in any other way. All the three conditions cannot be fulfilled simultaneously. Now, limitation of the law of EQ marginal utility. Now, the EQ marginal principle is subject to creating limitations, which might be set forth here under. First one, the law is based upon the assumption of relationality on part of the consumer, but in real life several obstacles my abstract relation behavior. Second one, this is law works out fully only if the goods are divisible. If the goods happen to be large and indivisible, it is not possible to equate the marginal utility of money spent on them. Third one, non-availability of creating goods prevents the consumers from maximizing their satisfaction out of their expenditure. Therefore, the law fails to work. Fourth one, prices of goods often fluctuate in the market, with the result that their utilities also keep changing from time to time. This prevents the working of the law. Fifth one, the law of maximum satisfaction will not be applicable to complementary goods. Sixth one, another limitation of this law is that there is no fixed accounting period for the consumer in which he can buy and consume goods. Seventh one, cardinal measurement of utility, marginal utility of money remaining constant, etc., are not realistic consumptions. They are not valid. Eighth one, it is assumed that the consumer has a perfect knowledge, but this is not correct. Now, importance of the law. This is also six types. First one is basic of consumer expenditure. Second, basics for savings and consumptions. Third one is in the field of productions. Fourth one is it is application to exchange. Fifth one is price determinations. Sixth one is public finance. Now, first one, basic of consumer expenditure is the expenditure pattern of every consumer is beside on this law. Second one is basic of savings and consumptions. A product consumer will try to distribute is limited, means between the present and future consumption, so has to have equal marginal utility in each. This is how the law guides us. Third one is in the field of productions, to the businessman and the manufacturer, the law is of special importance. He works towards the most economical combinations of the factors of production. For this, he will substitute one factor for another till their marginal productivities are the same. Fourth one is, it is application to exchange. This law works in all our exchanges. Exchange is nothing but substitutions of one thing for another. Fifth one is price determinations. This principle has an important bearing on the determinations of value and price. Public finance. Sixth one, public expenditure of a government conforms to this law. Taxes are also leveled in such a manner that the marginal sacrifice of each tax payer is equal. Thus, the law of substitution applies to all branches of economic theory.